It was a deadly weekend in Hazleton. A 26-year-old man was fatally shot by police at his Alter Street home after they say he made repeated grabs for his gun and pointed it at them. But family members who were in the home when it happened are claiming that's not the way it actually played out. Christina Papa spoke to the family, and the family also has some video that backs up their claims.
Yep, Kathy, well, the family members do have some video. They were outraged by reports released just days after the shooting on Alter Street, where the loved ones were fatally shot by an officer. The family has hired an attorney and plans to raise a case against police reports.
The family of Jonathan Gray says this video, taken just after Gray was shot, showing police activity and an ambulance arriving at their home, conflicts with the official police report. Police say a Hazleton officer shot the 26-year-old twice after he grabbed for his weapon that had fallen to the floor of the home's back porch. An HPD officer followed him from a fight about a block away. The report says when he made the grab and tried to point the gun at them, one of the officers shot him twice, fatally wounding him. But in an off-camera interview, Gray's family tells News 13 that the shooting actually happened in the family's kitchen, that his mother witnessed him being shot, and that the police movement in and out of the kitchen seen in this video backs that up.
While investigators haven't identified the officer who shot Jonathan Gray, people here on Alter Street say the officer had a history with Gray and his family, and it was an adversarial one.
The family did show News 13 pictures of the blood-stained kitchen tiles where the family says Gray was actually shot. A family member who was in the home when he was killed is charging that the officer knew what he was doing.
And nothing's adding up. All the evidence isn't adding up either. You know, the police officers are supposed to serve and protect, and instead, you know, they just assumed he was like everybody else when really he's not like that.
Girlfriend Christina Green says Gray was loving and hardworking. He spent much of his time at his business down the street, Ma and Pa's Deli.
The community is not taking it too well, you know, because they knew him as a good guy. You know, they don't understand why this happened.
Employee Julio Torres doesn't agree with police reports either.
He respects authority. You know, I don't believe that he would point a gun at a police officer and try to shoot him. That's crazy. That doesn't sound like him.
Family members say Gray was licensed to carry that weapon.
Yeah, he used it for work for security reasons, and it was his right. He was licensed to carry. He never pulled it. In the 3 years we were together, I've never, ever seen him pull a gun.
We did contact state police and the Luzerne County's district attorney's office. The matter is still under investigation, and they cannot comment at this time. Kathy?
And, you know, that's what makes it difficult for the police and investigators to review any charges. It's under investigation. They really can't say anything right now. Thanks, Christina.